Here, the top image is the vector design, and the bottom image is the JPEG image of a completed design. We will use it as a guide to paint the vector design with the wood images in the image palette. Let's open the image palette. The palette is similar to the color palette, except it will contain wood images. Next, we assign an image working folder. Create a new folder. Give it a name. ImagePaint will use this folder to store and manage our wood images. Now we open the wood images folder in the download folder. Select the scan images and drag them to Adobe Illustrator. To add these images, with the images still selected, click on the Add Selected Images button. As seen here, ImagePaint has created 6 subfolders, with 4 folders to contain the 4 images we just added. ImagePaint creates and names the image subfolder by taking the image name and removing everything after and including the last dash sign, if any. An empty folder called ImageLibs, which we will get into later, and a folder called Icons to store the image icons, where each icon represents all images in one of the 4 said folders. These image icons are the same icons we have seen in the image palette earlier.